ensure that you maintain this physique?
Well, I like to do a lot of cardio. So I do a lot of runs, I join a lot of fun runs, and my first 21K. And then of course I do my weights on the other days that I'm not doing cardio. So very, very important to balance cardio and weights. I'm curious though, because sometimes, especially for all of us who follow her Instagram account, we will see that you have an event that ends pretty late. Like one evening, and then the next day you're already at the gym working out. I'm curious, do you sleep?
I do.
Okay.
And I think we're just used to taking like little cat naps in the car or whenever we get the chance. But of course it's very important that you get enough sleep before you work out. I mean, it's just good for your body. You need recovery.
What about you? What's your fitness routine like?
Well, I live a very active lifestyle, but I do this 10-minute thing every morning. I work out for 10 minutes straight, three different exercises, which is just squats, push-ups, and sometimes an ab exercise or just mountain climbers. And I cycle in 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, and for 10 minutes straight. And basically, that's it. It's the heart rate up and start burning calories. And then I have my breakfast and my meals throughout the day.
As Anne has already mentioned, you were born with abs, so you're basically just maintaining what you were born with. Okay, what is your advice to those folks who cannot go to the gym regularly? How do they do this?
For me, you don't need to enroll yourself at a gym. If that helps you, then by all means, go ahead and do it. But there's so many things that you can do at home. When you wake up in the morning, the first thing you should do is actually get your heart rate going, so you burn calories the entire day. And there's different exercises that you can do just at home. So, but if it motivates you more, that you make the effort to enroll in a gym, drive to the gym, park your car, pay for the parking, and go to a gym, if that works for you, go ahead, do it. It's whatever fits your personality.
I think for women, it really helps when you have a fitspiration to keep you motivated. And what I like to do is when I have a fitspiration, dinidikit ko yung mga photos or posters na in my bathroom from the moment I wake up. Pag talagang alam ko kailangan ko mag-behave, I put the picture in my fridge so that when I open, okay, no chocolate for me muna. So I guess it helps when you have a fitspiration or when you find a workout buddy that you can work out with, so that you guys can push each other, right? Tamad na tamad na kayo.
I just like to add that don't deprive yourself of food.
Okay.
That's definitely
you have to have at least a cheat day.
You need to eat. You need to put gasoline into your car, right? Or to run properly. So food is our gasoline. We need to put food in our body so that we can function properly, so that our body can function properly.
Proper choice of food.
Take note, they're emphasizing how important food is, so it's not about starvation. Speaking of food, what food is part of your diet?
Yes. Of course, tuna is. Of course, century tuna in oil specifically. I think that works for me, and I can cook that anyway. I can put it, if I know I'm going to work out, I'll make a sandwich. If not, I'll mix it with an omelet.
Okay.
So, yeah. Tuna, eggs, and some healthy carbs.
Okay, Derek?
I probably consume about 3 to 4 cans of hot and spicy century tuna every day. Even on my cheat days, when I love pancit canton.
Oh, okay.
So I have 2 cans of hot and spicy.